We're about 3 miles short of Echo Golf Juliet, otherwise known as Jersey, and we're going to be looking at a moderate crosswind landing. Now, I could do this approach with approach flaps and an airspeed of about 75 knots, but I'm going to go with full flaps and the regulation 65 knot approach speed. As you can see on the PFD, the crosswind is 8 knots and it's coming from the north, which is directly to the left. Now what that is going to do is it's going to push us towards the right. You'll see at the end of this video that it does actually push us to the right. You can see the effect. It might look very subtle, but there is a real push to the right. The way to combat that is to point the aircraft a little bit to the left, so the nose of the aircraft is pointing a little left of the runway center line. The advantage, of course, of using approach flaps would be that we can maintain a slightly higher approach speed, and because the runway is quite long, that would be a perfectly acceptable approach to take. So this isn't going to be a perfect approach. I'm going to leave the slight mistake to illustrate what the crosswind is actually doing. So I'll compensate for that, or correct for that at the end before touchdown. The idea is to flare, or to go for the roundout and the flare, and then to correct the attitude of the aircraft with a little bit of right rudder, holding a little bit of left aileron to compensate for the crosswind before touchdown. As you can see, we're a little bit to the left, to the right, having to compensate and correct over the endpoint, starting to flare, a little bit of right rudder, left aileron, and touchdown. So it's not a perfect landing, but it is an example of what we're trying to achieve with a crosswind approach. As always, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe.